Hey guys, it's Holy Mushy here, and today I'm gonna talk about how to rally against Gnome camps or just fighting in general when we're rallying. And so, right here we have a level 3 Gnome camp. It's called the Gnome Frontline Camp Level 3. Requires some recommended troops of they have 150,000 units, so we know that they have a wave of 5 consisting that much units. And so a lot of things that new players make for their mistake is that they would just randomly go and attack these gnome camps, not knowing how strong they are, hoping that they can win out of it. But little to know that there's 5 different waves, so basically it's 5 different battles back to back with each of us. So we have here Holy Mushy, and that's me, and another alliance member named Mailforce. So first thing to know is, like, yeah, order of rally matters, because let's say I take down 2 waves, and then on the third wave my unit dies but did a little tiny of damage of, like, maybe a chunk, a third of the gnome's army, dirt army, right? And let's say the second friend I have as well with me is gonna start where I left off, so he's gonna be back at full health fighting that gnome with 100 HP, and you have a much easier time fighting it because they're gonna do less damage, because the damage of the gnomes is directly proportional to the amount of health they have. So if they're fighting at full HP, that means they're fighting at full strength, and if they're fighting at, let's say, half HP, they're fighting half their strength with their skills and abilities. And so this is why I emphasize, order of rally matters, because let's say I took off, like, let's say, for example, I take down one gnome army, and I lose for a second army, I took away half the HP. And let's say another friend of mine's, also with the relatively same army strength, took down the half army, first army, and this time he was, still pretty full HP because his water dragon healed him up. And then he fights the third gnome army, and he'll much have a much easier time. And so it's kind of like a cascading effect of, like, strong, send your strongest first and then attack with your weakest. And so that was my friend just telling me to kick him. And another thing to know is that a lot of these frontline camps, like these gnomes, they're often associated with special events. And so you only get credit for them when you defeat a gnome and participate in the rally. Meaning, if you don't join a rally, you don't get the effect. If you do join the rally and you guys win the fight, not only you be rewarded for the credit, you also get some reward right here. So this is my previous battle with a level 3 gnome camp. And you see here, you get these are loot, just 500 weapon gems, purple essence, and then Infinity Kingdom currency, and just some loot boxes for resources. So let's take a look at the details. So right here, this is my army. I took away the first army. I'm at half HP right here, or a little bit more than half. I fight the second gnome. Okay, gnome army. This time I did half of their health, but they took me down. And then my buddy here, Hachimon, his army took down the army, the gnome that beat me. And now he fights another gnome one, and this gnome camp utterly destroyed him because he's pretty big from the previous one. So it didn't really matter. So this is why order matters. If you send your weakest guy first, they're just gonna, like, straight up die. And in fact, might even heal the enemy gnomes. And then we have another strong alliance member. His name is Angry Polar. He's pretty similar to me. He straight up took down one camp by himself and died to the next one because he's low health. And then Hulk, he's a Hulk, he's a big guy. He took down this guy and the second camp on his own. And so, yeah, emphasis on, you wanna watch out for how much power you have, recommended power level, and that order matters when we're fighting this. And I hope that helps. That's it. Don't mind this.